Hello students, in the previous class we have seen the introduction of the volumetric analysis. In the classification also we have seen. So today let us discuss about acid-base titrations. So what is acid-base titrations? Before going to this, let us discuss about what is an acid, what is a base. So acid is nothing but what here? Loss of H plus ions. And base is nothing but we know the gain of H plus, or we can say loss of OH minus ions, according to Bronsted lower base theory. Okay, according to Bronsted lower base theory, what we are saying, that loss of H plus and gain of OH minus, we call it as base. And according to Lewis acid base theory, what we are going to say, Lewis acid base theory is nothing but acceptance of electron pairs, we call it as acid. Gain, losing of electron pairs, we call it as base, according to Lewis acid base theory. Okay, so we are saying that acid base titration. So acid base titration means, for example, I have taken in a one conical flask HCl and another conical flask NaOH. Okay, so when I have taken HCl, that is a strong acid, NaOH is also strong base. So here strong acid and strong base is interacting, so they both are titrating. So when you titrate, if you add some indicators, so when you add an indicator, what happens automatically? So if you add to the HCl the indicator, it will give colorless solution. That indicator, phenolphthalein indicator, if you add to the HCl, it will give colorless solution. If you add to the NaOH, it will give pale pink color. Okay, and same thing, if you add methyl orange indicator to the HCl, it will give pale pink. If you add NaOH, it will give colorless. So means what? Basing upon their acidic and basic nature, we are going to say. Okay, so coming to here, so this is the general introduction of the acid-base titrations. So we are having different types of indicators basing upon the pH values also. Here we are speaking about the acid-base titrations depends not only indicator, it depends, the indicator depends upon the pH values also. So what we can say, the acid-base titrations will depend upon the pH values also. So pH is nothing but what here? Concentration of hydrogen. It depends upon concentration of hydrogen ions. Okay, so depending upon H plus ions, the acid base titration is going to give the color. So in this, we are having the first titration is titration of strong acid and a strong base. Okay, so this is the titration of strong acid and a strong base we are taking. So in this, strong acid is nothing but we can take HCl, this is the strong acid, and strong base is nothing but NaOH. So this is nothing but strong base. So HCl is nothing but what here? This is a standard solution. So this solution we are going to take it in what here? This one we are going to take it in burette. And this one we are going to take it in pipette. Okay, so when you are adding here some indicator, you have to add, no? Okay, so I have told you, according to instrumental, it will give conductometric titrations. Okay, so this is a strong acid, strong base. And if you draw the graph here, when you draw the graph here, you are going to here on y-axis. See here, on x-axis we are taking volume of the solution, on y-axis you will be getting pH value. So this is a strong acid, this is the strong base. So then what happens, it will increase to 0 degrees and it will give straight curve, and again it goes on decreasing. So like S shape it is going to give. Okay, so this is the graph we are going to get when you take strong acid and strong base in conductometric titrations. So here then the pH value will be always equals to 7. So this one is a neutralization titration. Why it is neutralization titration is nothing but when you take HCl plus NaOH, what it will give? NaCl plus H2O, right? So it is giving water molecule. So when you goes on adding H plus ions to the OH minus ions, means Na plus ions, so then what happening here, this Na plus ions and here HCl, it is combining at one point. And so once again I'm repeating, see, so from burette you are adding to the solution, to the conical flask which is containing NaOH solution. So then what happens, you are adding the solution from the burette. So up to here, okay, both solutions we are having, pipette solution we are having and also HCl solution. Pipette solution we have taken only 20 ml. So when you go on adding, what happens, the HCl solution, the V remains only H plus ions here, and it will decrease the color basing upon the pH value. So then HCl only remains here, then again what happens, it is going to decrease. So by this what we can say, without adding any indicator we can easily get the pale pink color. So this is about strong acid and strong base. This is the graph, and here we are having the pH value almost 7. Next, coming to here, titration of weak acid, strong base. Weak acid is nothing but what here? Here we can produce conjugate acid and conjugate base. So what is conjugate acid, conjugate base pair? So in a equation, both acidic and basic nature, if it is showing, that one we call it as conjugate acid base pair. Okay, so that one we can see here now. So here I am taking here weak acid is nothing but CH3COOH, and strong base is nothing but NaOH. So this is a weak acid, this is a strong base. Then you are getting this equation as CH3COO minus Na plus H2O. It is giving, so means what, it is forming a salt. This weak acid is forming a salt which is giving a cation, right? So it is giving a strong conjugate acid. This is giving conjugate base, we can say strong conjugate base. So now what happens again, if you take CH3COO minus plus H2O, if you have been taken, it will give again when you do hydrolysis, which is in a reversible reaction, it is going to give CH3COOH plus OH minus. See here, I have taken weak acid, strong base, it is giving salt, okay, it is forming water molecule. If you have been taken this anion when you are doing hydrolysis, so when you are doing the anion, whatever it is produced when you do hydrolysis, it is giving what here, conjugate base. Okay, so this is the conjugate base. In the same reaction, it is forming acidic and also basic nature. That one we call it as conjugate acid base theory. So here we are saying what, titration of weak acid and strong base, means it is giving the base. So then what happens here, the pH value, how we are going to get the pH which is greater than 7. Okay, so the basic nature is nothing but here the pH will be always greater than 7. So then what we are going to get the curve here, again volume of this solution we are going to take on x axis, and on y axis we are going to take pH value. So here what happens, again when you add the solution like this, we are going to get, and the curve is getting, so means what, it is again increasing and decreasing. Okay, so here we are going to add indicators like phenolphthalein indicator. What is the indicator we are getting? Phenolphthalein indicator we are going to add to this titration, then only we are going to get the pale pink. Next we are going to get titration of strong acid and weak base. Here we got conjugate base. Here we are going to get conjugate acid. Okay, so coming to here, let us take example. Weak base is nothing but here NH4OH. Acid is nothing but HCl. When you are reacting, it is going to give NH4 plus Cl minus plus H2O. So we got acid and also base. So now this NH4 plus, when you react with water molecule, it is going to give NH3 plus H3O plus. So means what? This is a strong conjugate acid. Here the pH value, how we are getting? It will be less than 7. Okay, here the pH will be greater than 7. Here the pH will be less than 7. So here also same thing, the graph we are going to get, that is here the indicator to get the pale pink, we are using the indicator as a methyl orange indicator to get pale pink, which is taken as a endpoint. Okay, here phenolphthalein we are not going to use. So coming to here, same thing again, at 0 degrees it will form and at steep increase. So this is the pH, this is the volume of the solution. And last we are going to have here titration of weak acid and weak base. So when you have been seen here, the pH will be almost 4.5 to 8, like this it is going to help, more than 7 it is going to help. So here no indicator we are going to use. So weak acid is nothing but NH4OH and CH3COOH. When you add this one, what happens here? CH3COO minus plus NH4 plus plus H2. So means what? Here conjugate base, conjugate acid. This is the conjugate base it is forming, and this is the conjugate acid. So in a both reaction, weak acid, weak base, it is giving both acid and base. So then the graph we are going to get like this, some horizontal like this we are getting. Okay, so this is the volume of the solution, this is the pH. So this is about four types we are going to have. So we are saying no, here we are adding only methyl orange indicator, here we are adding phenolphthalein indicator. So we don't know which indicator for which reactions we have to add. Okay, so this one we are having two theories generally for acid base titrations, that is one is Ostwald theory or we can say ionic theory also, Ostwald theory or ionic theory. So generally when you take acids or bases, first of all it will divide it to ions, right? When you take acids and bases, it will divide it into ions. Means in all the acid base indicators, if you take whether it is weak acid or weak base, first of all it partially ionizes. Means for example, if I have taken H2O, how it is going to give H plus plus OH minus. So means what? Half giving H plus ions, half giving OH minus. It is giving OH minus, right? So means what? The ions is partially ionizing. So let us take for example, I have been taken here acid base indicator. In this we are having weak acid and here weak base. Let us take here. Okay, so if I take phenolphthalein indicator, so then what happens? I have been taken HPH. This is a phenolphthalein indicator. Okay, so then first of all what happens here? It will react with H plus plus pH minus. Okay, so then again this pH minus, when you react with water, then what happens? pHOH plus H plus. This is the phenolphthalein indicator. And coming to here, weak base. For weak base, I'm taking here same thing, that is HPH gives rise to H plus pH minus. Okay, so here I have been added HCl, then it is giving pHCl and H plus. So coming to here, I have taken base NaOH plus pH minus. What it is giving here? pH minus Na plus plus OH minus. See here, this is the phenolphthalein indicator. It is giving H plus ions and pH minus. This phenolphthalein indicator, when you react with HCl, means when you are adding to the HCl, it is giving what here? Colorless solution. It is giving pale pink. pH minus is giving pale pink, and this is giving colorless. Okay, and here also it is giving colorless solution, it is giving pale pink solution. But coming to here, so why it is giving colorless? If you have been seen here, in both the reactions we are having the same ions. So this is due to common ion effect, we can say. What is common ion effect? As we seen in the previous classes, so common ion effect is nothing but here the dissociation or separation of ions by own itself. That one we call it as common ion effect. Okay, whether it is weak acid or weak base, they can easily dissociate itself to the ions. That one we call it as common ion effect. So the common ion is here H plus. So due to this reason, what we can say, it is colorless, and we can add phenolphthalein to get the pale pink. And coming to here, weak base. Here, we, if you have been seen here, here OH minus ions it is giving, and there is no common ion here, right? So it can easily give the pale pink color. There is no colorless ions. So this is nothing but what, generally it depends, means what, partially ionization ends. Not only this, if you take methyl orange indicator, so for methyl orange indicator what happens? Again you take HME, then it will give H plus ME minus, and if you react with MeOH, it will give HCl, then it will give H2O plus MeCl. So means what here? Here there is no common ion effect. Coming to here again, we are going to get common ion effect. Okay, so this is the reason why we are adding phenolphthalein and this one. So this is about Ostwald theory we have been discussed. So means what, Ostwald theory is nothing but what, ionization theory. Whenever you take indicators, they can easily get partially divided into ions, that is H plus and OH minus ions. Okay, so coming to here, all the indicators with pH value, if it is less than 7, that one we call it as acid indicators. If it is greater than 7, we call it as base indicators. Okay, that's pH indicators. So base indicators is nothing but what here, which is undergoing ionization in acidic medium, means like methyl orange. So these all will come under the acid indicators. Methyl orange will come under what here? Methyl red, methyl orange will come under the acid indicators. Phenolphthalein will come under the base indicators. Okay, so means what here? Here the a conjugate acid base. So this is giving conjugate acid base pair. It will give different colors, and it will act as a indicator also. So this is nothing but Ostwald theory. And coming to next theory, we are having quinoid theory. So quinoid theory is nothing but to determine the structures. Basing upon structures, we can determine whether it is colored or colorless. Okay, so this one we call it as quinoid theory. So generally we have discussed Ostwald theory. So this ionic theory was successful when you add the indicator, but it cannot give the correct explanation of which indicator acquires the color, right? So we are saying that both will give color, but which indicator is giving perfect color, we are not going to explain in ionic theory. But coming to that part of thing was explained by quinoid theory. So which will give structure determination? Mainly if you have been taken benzene compounds, this is the benzene compound. If it is having, this is the benzonoid. If it is having like this, this one we call it as, this one is colorless structure. When you shift the bonds, it is going to get this structure like this. So this one will give quinoid structure, which will be a colored. So see here, the benzenes are the benzenoid structure, when you have been taken, so it is a colorless. So when the bonds are shifting automatically, when it is in conjugation, it is giving color structures. So by this, what we can say, these two structures are tautomers. We can say the shifting of bonds, we call it as what here, tautomeric structure, means migration of the bonds which is in equilibrium condition. Okay, so let us take an example of phenolphthalein indicator. Let us draw the structure of phenolphthalein. So this is the structure of the phenolphthalein. Indicator. Okay. So here we are having OH, no? Here bond is there, here OH is there, benzoyl. So this is the benzoyl structure. So which is a colorless. So this is the phenolphthalein indicator. So which, when you shift the bonds to this, okay, suppose if the bond is turning like this, here minus charge it is getting. So when you turn bond here, here double bond, and this bond will come here, this bond will come here, again this H plus will come and add here. So means what we are getting here, we are getting OH double bond O. So this is the color structure, which is a quinoid. So what we have told, the tautomeres of this benzoyl structure, we call it as quinoid structure. So coming to here, see here, it is a benzene ring. When you shift the bonds, here it is getting double bond and double bond O, which is a quinoid structure. It is giving what here, colored structure, which is a quinoid. So which will give red color structure. Okay, so when the migration is going to happen, so this is going to give the structure. So this is nothing but acid base theory. In acid base theory, we are having four, that is strong acid, strong base titration, strong acid, weak base, weak acid, strong base, and weak acid, weak base. So to determine the indicators, we are having two theories, that is Ostwald theory and quinoid theory. In Ostwald theory, we are going to speak about ions. In quinoid theory, we are going to speak about structures. Basing upon the ions, we can get the color, the indicators, and basing upon structure also, we can get the color of the structures. So this is nothing but acid base theory. In the next class, we can speak about redox reactions. Thank you.